One of the major movements in American education now is to get more students engaged in learning when it comes to science, technology, engineering, and math, often referred to as STEM. Hari Sreenivasan has a report from Chicago on efforts to boost science learning among some of the youngest students by boosting teacher confidence for our weekly segment, Making the Grade.
Who had fun?
Anyone who's spent time with 3-, 4-, and 5-year-olds knows children at this age ask a lot of questions. Preschool teacher Edward Marshall.
Kids are very persistent, and when they look at me, they want Mr. Marshall to have all the answers. Any question they ask me, they want me to have the answer to it.
Okay, where's my good listener? Okay.
Marshall, who leads a Head Start classroom in Chicago, says the children's unrestrained curiosity can sometimes make them feel anxious about teaching certain subjects like science.
I feel I don't want to fail them. I don't want to let them down.
Pick out one object.
Marshall is not alone. A recent study from Michigan State University found that a majority of preschool teachers experience the same discomfort teaching science.
I'll focus more on reading and not really look at the science because I thought it was complicated.
I'm not good with the science. I'm just uncomfortable with it.
I wasn't a big science person. I remember biology in high school, but that's about it.
With only 38% of the nation's fourth graders testing proficient in the sciences, some educators are looking to preschool to begin addressing the problem. Here at the University of Chicago, experts in science, technology, and math are partnering with local childcare centers to boost teacher confidence.
We hear all the time, teachers go into early education to avoid math and science courses themselves.
Leisha Spoppin and Liz Lehman from the University of Chicago's STEM Education Center say that when teachers feel uneasy about a subject matter, it can leave a powerful impression on students, even at an early age.
If you're afraid of it, if you have anxiety around a topic, you're very unlikely to want to teach it to your students as well. The problem is anxieties like that get passed down. If I'm anxious about something, my students see that in me. They think there must be a reason to be anxious about this.
When they find something engaging, and they start talking in ways.
Lehman and Spoppin have been coaching preschool teachers from Chicago's Austin neighborhood, where students from low-income families are at a greater risk of falling behind in science and math.
And we're gonna see what things can roll down this ramp. Okay, can you say the word ramp?
Ramp.
At Channing's Child Care Academy, teacher Odessa McBroom introduced a ramp while the coaches observed.
Let it go. Now what did it do?
The exercise allowed teachers to use a simple activity to teach physics.
What's that word I'm looking for? It's doing something.
Roll.
This is really getting into some of those physical science concepts. We're talking about things like gravity and friction. What do I notice when I send something down a ramp? Some of them will slide, some of them will roll, some of them will not move at all.
Now what you gonna have to do to make it move? You gotta push it, right? So if you push it, is it gonna slide down? They were curious. They wanna see what's gonna happen. That's what they love to know, what's going on.
I want you all to grab one object out of the bag.
Later in the day, Lehman and Spoppin observed children who gathered around a water tank at Betty's Daycare Academy to test which objects sink or float.
When you put it in the water, what do you think is going to happen to it? What did it do? It flows, yeah.
The science content there is around density and properties of water and properties of materials. We aren't expecting children to learn the word density. We just want three-year-olds to have those experiences to draw on. If you can go, oh yeah, I remember this when I was a little kid. I dropped things in the water and some floated and some didn't. Oh, that's density.
It's gonna flow.
Even with this simple activity, the teachers had moments of doubt, like when Marshall realized he didn't fully understand the properties of the materials.
I wanted them to stick their hand in the bag and then ask, what do you think it's made out of? And when I got to that part, I'm like, oh my God, I don't know what this is.
Later, he talked to the coaches about his insecure feelings.
Some of the objects, I didn't know what they were made of. So I was kind of thinking of, should I ask that question?
I'm a big believer that it's okay for teachers to say they don't know something.
You know what, you guys? I don't know. We'll have to investigate this, right? That's okay.
So I have a question.
Yes.
Why didn't the branch sink?
Marshall's teaching partner, Tina Smith Miller, had science questions of her own.
The kids were saying it was going to float. I thought it was going to sink. I didn't tell anybody I didn't know the answer either. I was keeping it to myself.
It's not an easy shift for teachers to make. It's something you feel as if you should know the answers to these things when kids ask you.
The university coaches do not teach science. Instead, the goal is to promote science inquiry.
If you feel uncomfortable about the answers, about giving the answers or finding the answers, you're going to avoid those questions. What we always tell teachers is use those opportunities. It's okay if you have to say, let's figure this out together.
And that gave me the courage to ask more questions. And it wasn't a wrong answer, or I didn't feel silly or scared or afraid. So I think they helped me be more courageous.
I learned a lot about exploring, finding things out, doing a lot of investigating. We had a lot of trial and error.
I should have learned it a long time ago. And I'm so glad that we got involved in this program, because I said, okay, I need some help on this. Everything else, I got it. This, that didn't happen.
The teacher coaches hope to expand their early learning project in the coming years. In Chicago, for the PBS NewsHour, I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Okay.